getting ready to start. Let's not do that. You know what? If you give me the F sharp and the G, sorry, F sharp, G sharp, that would be more helpful.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
amen.
The Lord be with you. Dear brothers and sisters, on this most holy night, in which our Lord Jesus Christ passed over from death to life, the Church calls upon her sons and daughters scattered throughout the world to come together to watch and pray. If we keep the memorial of the Lord's Paschal solemnity in this way, listening to His word and celebrating His mysteries, then we shall have a sure hope of sharing His triumph over death and living with Him in God. And now we bless the fire. O God, who through your Son bestowed upon the faithful the fire of your glory, sanctify this new fire, we pray, and grant that these Paschal celebrations we may be so inflamed with heavenly desires that with minds made pure we may attain festivities of unending splendor through Christ our Lord. Christ, yesterday and today, the beginning and the end, the Alpha and the Omega, all time belongs to Him, and all the ages, to Him be glory and power through every age, forever and ever.
Amen.
By this holy, His holy and glorious wounds, may Christ the Lord guard us and keep us forever and ever.
Amen.
May Christ rising in glory dispel the darkness of our hearts and our minds.
exalt, let them exalt the hosts of heaven. Exalt, let angel ministers of God exalt. Let the trumpet of salvation sound aloud, our mighty King's triumph. Be glad, let earth be glad as glory floods her, ablaze with light from her eternal King. Let all corners of the earth be glad, knowing an end to gloom and darkness. Rejoice, let Mother Church also rejoice, arrayed with the lightning of his glory. Let this holy building shake with joy, filled with the mighty voices of the peoples. It is truly right and just, with ardent love of mind and heart, and with devoted service of our voice, to acclaim our God invisible, the Almighty Father, and Jesus Christ, our Lord, his Son, his only begotten, who for our sake paid Adam's debt to the eternal Father, and pouring out his own dear blood, wiped clean the record of our ancient sinfulness. These then are the feasts of Passover, in which is slain the Lamb, the one true Lamb, whose blood anoints the doorposts of believers. This is the night when once you led our forebears, Israel's children, from slavery in Egypt, and made them pass dry shod through the Red Sea. This is the night that with a pillar of fire banished the darkness of sin. This is the night that even now throughout the world sets Christian believers apart from worldly vices and from the gloom of sin, leading them to grace and joining them to his holy ones. This is the night when Christ broke the prison bars of death and rose victorious from the underworld. Our birth would have been no gain had we not been redeemed. O wonder of your humble care for us, O love, O charity beyond all telling, to ransom a slave, you gave away your Son. O truly necessary sin of Adam, destroyed completely by the death of Christ. O happy fault that earned so great, so glorious a Redeemer. O truly blessed night, worthy alone to know the time and hour when Christ rose from the underworld. This is the night of which it is written, The night shall be as bright as day. Dwelling is the night for me, and full of gladness. The sanctifying power of this night dispels wickedness, washes all faults away, restores innocence to the fallen, and joy to mourners, drives out hatred, fosters concord, and brings down the mighty. On this, your night of grace, O Holy Father, accept this candle, a solemn offering, the work of bees and of your servants' hands, an evening sacrifice of praise, this gift from your most holy church. But now we know the praises of this pillar, which glowing fire ignites for God's honor. A fire into many flames divided, yet never dimmed by sharing of its light. For it is fed by melting wax, drawn out by mother bees to build a torch so precious. Oh, truly blessed night, when things of heaven are wed to those of earth and divine to the human. Therefore, O Lord, we pray you, that this candle, hallowed to the honor of your name, may persevere undimmed to overcome the darkness of this night. Receive it as a pleasing fragrance, and let it mingle with the lights of heaven. May this flame be found still burning by the morning star, the one morning star who never sets, Christ your Son, who coming back from death's domain has shed his peaceful light on humanity, and lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen.
Let us pray. Dear brothers and sisters, now that we have begun our solemn vigil, let us listen with quiet hearts to the Word of God. Let us meditate on how God in times past saved His people, and in these last days has sent us His Son, our Redeemer. Let us pray that our God may complete the paschal work of salvation by the fullness of redemption.
Wish your candles. A reading from the book of Genesis. In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth was a formless wasteland, and darkness covered the abyss, while a mighty wind swept over the waters. Then God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. God saw how good the light was. God then separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. Thus, evening came, and morning followed the first day. Then God said, "Let there be a dome in the middle of the waters to separate one body of water from the other." And so it happened. God made the dome, and it separated the water above the dome from the water below it. God called the dome the sky. Evening came, and morning followed the second day. Then God said, "Let the water under the sky be gathered into a single basin, so that the dry land may appear." And so it happened. The water under the sky was gathered into its basin, and the dry land appeared. God called the dry land the earth, and the basin of the water he called the sea. God saw how good it was. Then God said, "Let the earth bring forth vegetation, every kind of plant that bears seed, and every kind of fruit tree on earth that bears fruit with its seed in it." And so it happened. The earth brought forth every kind of plant that bears seed, and every kind of fruit tree on earth that bears fruit with its seed in it. God saw how good it was. Evening came, and morning followed the third day. Then God said, "Let there be lights in the dome of the sky to separate day from night. Let them mark the fixed times, the days and the years, and serve as luminaries in the dome of the sky to shed light upon the earth." And so it happened. God made the two great lights, the greater one to govern the day and the lesser one to govern the night. And he made the stars. God set them in the dome of the sky to shed light upon the earth, to govern the day and the night, and to separate the light from the darkness. God saw how good it was. Evening came, and morning followed the fourth day. Then God said, "Let the water teem with an abundance of living creatures, and on the earth let birds fly beneath the dome of the sky." And so it happened. God created the great sea monsters and all kinds of swimming creatures with which the water teems, and all kinds of winged birds. God saw how good it was, and God blessed them, saying, "Be fertile, multiply, and fill the water of the seas, and let the birds multiply on the earth." Evening came, and morning followed the fifth day. Then God said, "Let the earth bring forth all kinds of living creatures, cattle, creeping things, and wild animals of all kinds." And so it happened. God made all kinds of wild animals, all kinds of cattle, and all kinds of creeping things of the earth. God saw how good it was. Then God said, "Let us make man in our image, after our likeness. Let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, the birds of the air, and the cattle, and over all the wild animals and all the creatures that crawl on the ground." God created man in his image. In the image of God, he created him. Male and female, he created them. God blessed them, saying, "Be fertile and multiply. Fill the earth and subdue it. Have dominion over the fish of the sea, the birds of the air, and all the living things that move on the earth." God also said, "See, I give you every seed-bearing plant all over the earth, and every tree that has seed-bearing fruit on it to be your food, and to all the animals of the land, all the birds of the air, and all the living creatures that crawl on the ground, I give all the green plants for food." So it happened. God looked at everything he had made, and he found it very good. Evening came, and morning followed, the sixth day. Thus the heavens and the earth and all their array were completed. Since on the seventh day God was finished with the work he had been doing, he rested on the seventh day from all the work he had undertaken. The word of the Lord.
Lord, send out your spirit and renew the face of the earth. Lord, send out your spirit and renew the face of the earth. Bless the Lord, O my soul. O Lord, my God, you are great indeed. How manifold are your works, O Lord! The earth is full of your creatures. Lord, send out your spirit and renew the face of the earth. Lord, send out your spirit and renew the face of the earth. If you take away their breath, they die, and they return to their dust. When you send forth your spirit of life, they are created in your sight. Lord, send and renew the face of the earth. Lord, send out your spirit and renew the face of the earth.
Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, who are wonderful in ordering of all your works, may those you have redeemed understand that there exists nothing more marvelous than the world's creation in the beginning, except that at the end of the ages, Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of Genesis. God put Abraham to the test. He called to him, "Abraham." "Here I am," he replied. Then God said, "Take your son, Isaac, your only one whom you love, and go to the land of Moab, Moriah. There you shall offer him up as a holocaust on a height that I will point out to you." Early the next morning, Abraham saddled his donkey, took with him his son Isaac and two of his servants as well, and with the wood that he had cut for the holocaust, set out for the place of which God had told him. On the third day, Abraham got sight of the place from afar. Then he said to his servants, "Both of you stay here with the donkey, while the boy and I go over there. We will worship and then come back to you." Thereupon, Abraham took the wood for the holocaust and laid it on his son Isaac's shoulders, while he himself carried the fire and the knife. As the two walked on together, Isaac spoke to his father Abraham. "Father," Isaac said. "Yes, son," he replied. Isaac continued, "Here are the fire and the wood, but where is the sheep for the holocaust?" "Son," Abraham answered, "God himself will provide the sheep for the holocaust." Then the two continued going forward. When they came to the place of which God had told him, Abraham built an altar there and arranged the wood on it. Next, he tied up his son Isaac and put him on top of the wood on the altar. Then he reached out and took the knife to slaughter his son. But the Lord's messenger called to him from heaven, "Abraham, Abraham." "Here I am," he answered. "Do not lay your hand on the boy," said the messenger. "Do not do the least thing to him. I know now how devoted you are to God, since you did not withhold from me your own beloved son." As Abraham looked about, he spied a ram caught by its horns in the thicket. So he went and took the ram and offered it up as a holocaust in place of his son. Abraham named the place Yahweh Yireh. Hence, people now say, "On the mountain the Lord will see." Again, the Lord's messenger called to Abraham from heaven and said, "I swear by myself, declares the Lord, that because you acted as you did in not withholding from me your beloved son, I will bless you abundantly and make your descendants as countless as the stars of the sky and the sands of the seashore. Your descendants shall take possession of the gates of their enemies, and in your descendants all the nations of the earth shall find blessing. All this because you obeyed my command." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Sure.
shall be my one home. You are my inheritance, O Lord. You are my inheritance, O Lord. From of old you are my heritage, you my wisdom and my safety. Through the night you speak within my heart, silently you teach me. You are my inheritance, O Lord. You are my inheritance, O Lord.
Let us pray. O God, Supreme Father of the faithful, who increased the children of your promise by pouring out the grace of adoption throughout the whole world, and all who through the Paschal mystery make your servant Abraham father of nations, as once you swore, grant, we pray, that your peoples may enter worthily in the grace to which you call them, through Christ our Lord.
A reading from the book of Exodus. The Lord said to Moses, "Why are you crying out to me? Tell the Israelites to go forward. And you, lift up your staff, and with hand outstretched over the sea, split the sea in two, that the Israelites may pass through it on dry land. But I will make the Egyptians so obstinate that they will go in after them. Then I will receive glory through Pharaoh and all his army, his chariots and charioteers. The Egyptians shall know that I am the Lord when I receive glory through Pharaoh, his chariots and charioteers." The angel of God, who had been leading Israel's camp, now moved around and went behind them. The column of cloud, also leaving the front, took up its place behind them, so that it came between the camp of the Egyptians and that of Israel. But the cloud now became dark, and thus the night passed without the rival camps coming any closer together all night long. Then Moses stretched out his hand over the sea, and the Lord swept the sea with a strong east wind throughout the night, and so turned it to dry land. When the water was thus divided, the Israelites marched into the midst of the sea on dry land, with the water like a wall to their right and to their left. The Egyptians followed in pursuit. All Pharaoh's horses and chariots and charioteers went after them right into the midst of the sea. In the night watch, just before dawn, the Lord cast through the column of the fiery cloud upon the Egyptian force a glance that threw it into a panic, and he so clogged their chariot wheels that they could hardly drive. With that, the Egyptians sounded the retreat before Israel, because the Lord was fighting for them against the Egyptians. Then the Lord told Moses, stretch out your hand over the sea, that the water may flow back upon the Egyptians, upon their chariots and their charioteers. So Moses stretched out his hand over the sea, and at dawn the sea flowed back to its normal depth. The Egyptians were fleeing head on toward the sea when the Lord hurled them into its midst. As the water flowed back, it covered the chariots and the charioteers of Pharaoh's whole army, which had followed the Israelites into the sea. Not a single one of them escaped. But the Israelites had marched on dry land through the midst of the sea, with the water like a wall to their right and to their left. Thus the Lord saved Israel that day from the power of the Egyptians. When Israel saw the Egyptians lying dead on the seashore and beheld the great power that the Lord had shown against the Egyptians, they feared the Lord and believed in him and in his servant Moses. Then Moses and the Israelites sang this song to the Lord. I will sing to the Lord, for he is gloriously triumphant. Horse and chariot he has cast into the sea. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to
God. Let us sing to the Lord, he has covered himself in glory. Let us sing to the Lord, he has covered himself in glory. I will sing to the Lord who has triumphed in glory. Horse and rider are flung into the sea. My strength and my refuge is the Lord who saves me. I sing my praise, I extol God's victory. Let us sing to the Lord, he has covered himself in glory. The Lord is a warrior whose name is the Lord. Pharaoh's army is flung into the sea. The greatest of officers are drowned in the Red Sea. Let us sing to the Lord, he has covered himself in glory.
Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, sole hope of the world, who by the preaching of your prophets unveiled the mysteries of this present age, graciously increase the longing of your people, for only at the prompting of your grace do the faithful progress in any kind of virtue, through Christ our Lord. Gloria in excelsis Deo. There is one more reading, I'm told, so please sit down.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, all you who are thirsty, come to the water. You who have no money, come, receive grain and eat. Come without paying and without cost, drink wine and milk. Why spend your money for what is not bread, your wages for what fails to satisfy? Heed me, and you shall eat well. You shall delight in rich fare. Come to me heedfully, listen, that you may have life. I will renew with you the everlasting covenant, the benefits assured to David. As I made him a witness to the peoples, a leader and a commander of nations, so shall you summon a nation you knew not, and nations that knew you not shall run to you. Because of the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, who has glorified you. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call him while he is near. Let the scoundrel forsake his way, and the wicked man his thoughts. Let him turn to the Lord for mercy, to our God, who is generous in forgiving. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor are your ways my ways, says the Lord. As high as the heavens are above earth, so high are my ways above your ways, and my thoughts above your thoughts. For just as from the heavens the rain and snow come down and do not return there till they have watered the earth, making it fertile and fruitful, giving seed to the one who sows and bread to the one who eats, so shall my word be that goes forth from my mouth. My word shall not return to me void, but shall do my will, achieving the end for which I sent it. The word of the Lord.
We shall draw water joyfully, singing joyfully, singing joyfully. We shall draw water joyfully from the wellsprings of salvation. We shall draw water joyfully, singing joyfully, singing joyfully. We shall draw water joyfully from the wellsprings of salvation. Truly God is our salvation. We trust, we shall not fear, for the Lord is our strength, the Lord is our song. He became our Savior. Singing joyfully, we shall draw water joyfully from the wellsprings of salvation. Give thanks, oh, give thanks to the Lord. Give praise to his holy name. Make his mighty deeds known to all of the nations. proclaim his greatness.
We shall draw
water joyfully, singing joyfully, singing joyfully. We shall draw water joyfully from the wellsprings of salvation.
Let us pray. O God, whose ancient wonders remain undimmed in splendor even in our day, for what you were once bestowed on a single people, freeing them from Pharaoh's persecution, by the power of your right hand, now you bring about as the salvation of the nations. Through the waters of rebirth, grant, we pray, that the whole world may become children of Abraham, and inherit the dignity of Israel's birthright, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I'm gonna do this again. Gloria in excelsis Deo. Let us pray. O God, who make the most sacred night radiant with the glory of the Lord's resurrection, stir up in your church a spirit of adoption, so that renewed in body and mind, we may render you undivided service. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, are you unaware that we who were baptized into Jesus Christ were baptized into his death? We were indeed buried with him through baptism into death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we too might live in newness of life. For if we have grown into union with him through a death like this, we shall also be united with him in the resurrection. We know that our old self was crucified with him so that our sinful body might be done away with, that we might no longer be in slavery to sin. For a dead person has been absolved of sin. If then we have died with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him. We know that Christ, raised from the dead, dies no more. Death no longer has power over him. As to his death, he died to sin once and for all. As to his life, he lives for God. Consequently, you too must think of yourselves as being dead to sin and living for God in Christ Jesus. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of James, and Salome brought spices so that they might go and anoint him. Very early, when the sun had risen on the first day of the week, they came to the tomb. They were saying to one another, "Who will roll back the stone for us from the entrance to the tomb?" When they looked up, they saw that the stone had been rolled back. It was very large. On entering the tomb, they saw a young man sitting on the right side, clothed in a white robe, and they were utterly amazed. He said to them, "Do not be amazed. You seek Jesus of Nazareth, the crucified. He has been raised. He is not here. Behold the place where they laid him. But go and tell his disciples and Peter, 'He is going before you to Galilee. There you will see him, as he told you.'" The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good evening, church. Happy Easter! Can you greet the people around you? Happy Easter!
Happy Easter.
God is good. And all the time. My friends, today I want to share with you the good news. Hope is alive. Because of Easter. Hope is alive because of Easter. Can we say that together?
Hope is alive because of Easter.
Church, you cannot live without hope. You cannot live without hope. During a brutal study at Harvard in the 1950s, Dr. Kurt Richter placed rats in a pool of water to test how long they could thread water. On average, they give up and sink after 3 minutes. There was a second group of rats that right before they gave up due to exhaustion, the researchers would pluck them out for a few minutes and then put them back for a second round. In the second try, how long do you think they lasted? Guess?
One minute.
1 minute. Yes? Huh? Another 3 minutes? Anything? Anybody else? Huh? One minute? What else? Yes. 10 minutes? 10 minutes? 5 minutes? Who says 10 minutes? Raise up your hand. 5 minutes? Raise up your hand. No. 60 hours. 60 hours. That's right. 60 hours of swimming. How many good swimmers do we have in the house? God bless you. The conclusion drawn was that since the rats believed that they would eventually be rescued, they would push their bodies way past that previously thought impossible. If hope can cause exhausted rats to swim for that long, what could a belief that there is a God who favors you, a God who would never leave you, a God who accepts you as you are, who always forgives you and tells you daily that you are His beloved child, do for you? Church, you cannot live without hope. A lot of people think that we believe in Easter because of the movement called Christianity, or a library of books we call the Bible. Nope. We believe because of the event that inspired a movement that gave us the Bible. Can we read that together? We believe because of the event, a movement. When Jesus died on the cross, the man Jesus of Nazareth, who lived accordingly to recorded and undisputed history, the Jesus they thought who was going to overthrow the Romans, the Empire of Rome, so did the followers' hope, died. His followers did not expect anything because dead people do what dead people do. They remain dead. So they planned to go back to their former way of life. You would have found in that moment of dead Jesus, no Christians, no believers, no followers. Even Mother Mary in recorded history thought that Jesus was dead. Why bother with the dream of a Messiah in Jesus? The centerpiece of Jesus' ministry was not his teaching. Let me repeat that. The centerpiece of Jesus' ministry was not his teaching. In fact, his teaching was incredibly impractical. Love your enemies. Do good to those who hate you. Pay your taxes. Did you hear me? Lust equals adultery. Turn the other cheek. Jesus did not ask people to trust his ideas or to follow his instructions. He asked people to follow him and to put their trust in him. It was not his ideas and teachings that got him crucified. It's who he claimed to be. He claimed to be God. And when Jesus died, so was the movement. Rome has won. There were no Jesus followers when he died. No church, no Bible. Everybody, including his mother, thought that Jesus would do what dead people were expected to do. Stay dead. My friends, you cannot live without hope. No wonder Easter changed everything. This event was the greatest hope that changed everything. Suddenly, his followers were no longer afraid and were ready to be killed for him. Thousands have in the year 33 AD. Now Rome, the empire that killed him like a criminal, is now full of monuments and buildings dedicated to his memory. And today, 2.6 billion people follow him. Not because of the movement nor of the Bible, but because of the event that happened 2,000 years ago that we celebrate today. My friends, you cannot live without hope. Easter is the reason why the Catholic Church worldwide has 18,000 clinics for the poor, 1,600 homes for the elderly and those with special needs, 5,500 hospitals around the world, and 63% of these healthcare facilities can be found in third world countries. We are the largest non-governmental provider of healthcare in the world, even here in the United States. We were the ones who started hospitals in the Western history, as well as universities. In our area alone, Election Brothers Hospital and St. Alexis Hospital, unbeknownst to many, are the centers of medical charity. The poor know where to go for compassion, in which welcome never ends. Our own parish alone has several ministries to the poor. Even in the Philippines, as we send poor children from the mountaintop to school, from K to 12 to college. Why? Because of this wonderful event we call Easter. The resurrected Christ is the reason that moved Mother Teresa of Calcutta to care for the poorest of the poor in the slums all over the world. Easter was the reason that Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. fought and died for freedom. Easter is the reason John Newton, that famous slave trader who became an abolitionist because of Christ, wrote Amazing Grace in 1779. My friend, you cannot live without hope. Hope is alive because Jesus is alive. Can we say that together with all our lungs? Hope
is alive because Jesus is alive.
There's this single mother in our church that cares so sacrificially for her little ones as she brings them to Mass every week inside that St. Anne's Chapel. There's this physically challenged wife I see weekly being tenderly cared for by her soft-spoken husband because of Jesus. There's this cancer-fighting widow and grandmother gathering all of her strength as she walks on her walker, struggling to navigate our aisles. I could go on and on, as I've seen so many witnesses to the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ, our hope alive here at St. Walter's. My friend, you cannot live without hope. There is this kid in our parish and in school who is now battling cancer. It's so hard to paint the pain and grief of his parents as cancer came back with a vengeance this second time around. They always have reached out to me as I walk with them this valley of tears. Hope for them is a cure, of course, but mostly hope for them is love, because only love heals. I journey with them because of my belief in Jesus, our hope alive. For us Christians, hope is not just an emotion. It is a person, Jesus of Nazareth. My friend, you cannot live without hope. Where do you need this hope today, my friend? Have you lost your job? Is there a relationship you miss? Are you battling with cancer right now? Are you in some kind of addiction? Are you exhausted, worn out, or lifeless, or afraid? Do you crave for meaning, drowning in the abyss of life? Are you experiencing regrets, depression, loneliness, or boredom? My friend, you cannot live without hope. I cannot live without hope. People often ask me, Father Mario, why do you like going to the Philippines with the college students of our diocese to build houses for the poor, doing construction in a 96-degree weather? It's not easy. A lot of you know this. You know, Mother Teresa was once asked by a reporter from England when she was removing the maggots from a dying man in the streets of Calcutta, as she brought them to the house of the dying, as she carefully removed the maggots The reporter said, "I wouldn't do that for $1 million." And Mother Teresa said, "I wouldn't either." But for Jesus, I would. Jesus, hope alive is reason enough, my friend. For better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in life, He alone offers that hope. Where do you need this hope tonight? Can we bow our heads in prayer? If your loved one is here, please hold their hand. Tonight, on this night, in all of the 1,000 churches throughout the world, we become people of hope. And so we lift up all of our concerns tonight to Christ, our hope, knowing that love heals, hope heals, Jesus heals. Heavenly Father, on this most glorious night, we give you thanks. And we give you thanks for giving us the resurrected Jesus, our hope. There's people in the house today that need this fervent hope tonight. There's people in the house today that are broken by this world and by so many questions and experiences of life. Father, we need hope tonight. And we ask that by the power of your Holy Spirit, please give us, Jesus, our hope alive. Because Jesus is enough for all of our needs, for all of our brokenness, and for all of our pain. So give us Jesus. This is our prayer. In Jesus' name, amen. Alleluia. As we celebrate the sacrament of initiation.
I would like to call Pong Kroll and Evan Glowinski forward with your godparents and family.
Pray for us.
Dear friends, let us pray to Almighty God for Pong and Evan, who are asking for baptism. God has called them and brought them to this moment. May God grant them light and strength to follow Jesus Christ with resolute hearts and to profess the faith of the Church. May God give them the new life of the Holy Spirit, whom we are about to call down on this water. Almighty and ever-living God, be present by the mysteries of your great love and send forth the spirit of adoption to create the new peoples brought to birth for you in the font of baptism, so that what is to be carried out by our humble service may be brought to fulfillment by your mighty power through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And we bless these waters of baptism. O God, who by invisible power accomplished a wondrous effect through the sacramental signs, and who in many ways have prepared water, your creation, to show forth the grace of baptism. O God, whose Spirit in the moments of the world's creation hovered over the water, so that the very substance of water would even take to itself the power to sanctify. O God, who by the outpouring of the flood foreshadowed regeneration, so that from the mystery of one and the same element of water would come an end to vice and the beginning of virtue. O God, who caused the children of Abraham to pass dry shod through the Red Sea, so that the chosen people set free from slavery to Pharaoh would prefigure a people, the people of the baptized. O God, whose Son, baptized by John in the waters of the Jordan, was anointed by the Holy Spirit, and as he hung upon the cross, gave forth water from his side along with blood, and after his resurrection commanded his disciples, "Go forth, teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit." Look now, we pray, upon the face of your Church, and graciously unseal for her the fountain of baptism. May this water receive by the Holy Spirit the grace of your only begotten Son, so that human nature created in your image and washed clean through the sacrament of baptism from all the squalor of life of old may be found worthy to rise to the life of the newborn children through the water and the Holy Spirit. May the power of the Holy Spirit, O Lord, come down through your Son in the fullness of this font, so that all who have been crucified with Christ by baptism into death may rise again to life with him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. I invite all to join with Pong and Evan to profess your faith. Please rise. And your answer will be, "I do." Do you renounce sin so as to live in the freedom of the children of God?
I do.
Do you renounce the lure of evil so that sin may have no mastery in you?
I do.
Do you renounce Satan, the author and prince of sin?
I do.
Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is now seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
I do.
And may the Almighty God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed on us forgiveness of our sins, keep us by His grace in Christ our Lord for eternal life, forever and ever. Pong, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Evan, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. So as Pong and Evan has received their baptism into Christ at this time, we shall also recall our baptism. I will now sprinkle upon you the waters of baptism as you have all been baptized into Christ. God, the all-powerful Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, has given us a new birth by water and the Holy Spirit and forgiven all of our sins. May He also keep us faithful to our Lord Jesus Christ forever and ever. Become a new creation and have clothed yourselves in Christ. Receive this baptismal garment. And bring it unstained to the judgment seat of our Lord Jesus Christ, so that you may have everlasting life forever and ever. Kong and Evan, receive the light of Christ. You have been enlightened by Christ. Walk always as children of the light and keep the flame of faith alive in your hearts. When the Lord comes, may you go out to meet Him with all the saints of the heavenly kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Church, may I present to you the newly baptized members of our Catholic Christian family, Pong and Evan. Now we will celebrate the sacrament of confirmation. Dear Pong and Evan, born again in Christ by baptism, you have become members of Christ and of His priestly people. Now you are to share in the outpouring of the Holy Spirit among us, the Spirit sent by the Lord to the apostles at Pentecost and given by them and their successors to the baptized. The promise and strength of the Holy Spirit, which you are to receive, will make you more like Christ and help you to witness to his suffering, death, and resurrection. It will strengthen you to be an active member of the church, his family, and to build up the body of Christ in faith and love. My dear friends, my dear people here at St. Walter's, let us ask God our Father that he will pour his Holy Spirit on this newly baptized Pong and Evan to strengthen them with his gifts and to anoint them to be more like Christ, the Son of God. All-powerful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, by water and the Holy Spirit, you freed your sons and daughters and gave them new life. Send your Holy Spirit upon Pong and Evan to be their helper and guide. Give them the spirit of wisdom and understanding, the spirit of right judgment and courage, the spirit of knowledge and reverence. Fill them with the spirit of wonder and awe in your presence. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Pong, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Evan, be sealed with the gift of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. Church, let us welcome our newly confirmed Congratulations! Welcome! Welcome to the family. Please rise for the universal prayers. On this glorious night, we look to the one with the power to raise the dead, asking for God's kindness and mercy upon all those who are in need.
For the church, reborn in the risen Lord, that we may continually bear witness to the effect of the resurrection on our lives, giving us and the world joy, hope, and peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the resurrection of our Lord may bring comfort to those who suffer, hope to those in despair, and new life to all those who are dying. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the risen Lord may move the hearts of all those who are in conflict with one another, whether in wars between nations or grudges between neighbors, bringing peace and reconciliation to all God's children. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the newest members of the church, especially Pong and Evan, that the good work the Lord has begun in them may continue to bear fruit. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
for our children preparing to come to the table of the Lord for the first time, and the students who will be confirmed. May they be filled with fervor and joy. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are ill and in need of our prayers, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have died, and for all whose names are enrolled in the Easter Novena of Masses, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Together, our Easter prayer. Most loving Trinity of love, we give you thanks and praise for all the blessings of this Easter season. The 30 days of Easter cause us to joyfully follow the risen Christ, to be his great witnesses of love, peace, and joy to a world hungry for his compassionate presence. Bless us with your Holy Spirit to be his hands, his feet, and his heart, to feed the hungry, to comfort the suffering, to clothe the naked, and to include the outsider, and to give generously to the poor. We want to be a church according to the divine mercy, whose welcome never ends. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Mother Mary, undoer of knots, pray for us. Saint Walter, friend of those under stress, pray for us.
Oh.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may become acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, the praise and glory of his name, for our good and all his holy church.
Accept, we ask, O Lord, the prayers of your people with the sacrificial offerings, that what has begun in the Paschal mysteries may, by the working of your power, bring us to the healing of eternity. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this night above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts that you have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said a blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said a blessing. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which may be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Walter, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope, Ronald our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Praising the Father for our risen Savior Jesus Christ, our hope alive, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord may always be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer one another a sign of peace.
Take away the sins of the world.
Brothers and sisters, behold our hope alive, Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Where two or three are gathered in my name, there I am in the midst of them, there I'll be. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, give the glory and the honor to the Lord, to the
Amen. body of Christ. Body of Christ. Body of Christ.
Hold on.
Let us pray. Pour out on us, O Lord, the spirit of your love, and in your kindness make those you have nourished by this Paschal sacrament one in mind and heart, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Happy Easter, everyone. This is Father Mario. God is good all the time, and all the time God is good. I am so happy that you are home. This is your home. St. Walter is your home, and you are loved and accepted here. And we are so enthused and so happy that you are here. Please remember that you belong here at St. Walter's, and that we always love that you are here, and hope that our home is also your home. Because here at St. Walter's, our home is Jesus. And Easter is the reason why we do all we do, in serving one another, in taking care of each other, in welcoming the stranger, especially the outsider. Jesus is that reason, because hope is alive. So thank you and welcome to St. Walter. Please come and join us every week. We would love to have you with us every week to worship the Lord in spirit and in truth with great enthusiasm and warmth. And as a gift for you, St. Walter will provide this great book, a best-selling book by Bo Sanchez. He is the best-selling author from the Philippines, a layperson, but such a great evangelist he is. He is, there's so many of us priests and bishops and cardinals that admire of him. So get a copy for yourself and for your loved ones. We have enough for everybody. And I love how this is about heart detox. Heart detox. So come, and somebody will hand it over after Mass today. And again, welcome to St. Walter's. I love you guys. This is again your pastor, Father Mario Quijadas. Happy Easter.
For those that are guests here at St. Walter's, can we give them a round of applause of welcome, those of our guests? And I would like to thank the Lent team and our OCIA team and our liturgy team, and so many teams here at St. Francis that made this the greatest 40 days of Lent ever. So let's give all of our wonderful volunteers, joyful disciples, a round of applause.
Bow down for the blessing.
May Almighty God bless you through tonight's Easter solemnity, and in his compassion defend you from every assault of sin. Amen. May he who restores you to eternal life in the resurrection of his only begotten endow you with the price of immortality.
Amen.
Now that the days of the Lord's passion have drawn to a close, may you who celebrate the gladness of the Paschal feast come with Christ's help and exulting in spirit to those feasts that are celebrated in eternal joy.
Amen.
And may the Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace of the risen Christ. Alleluia.
Alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Together to our Blessed Mother, the Regina Coeli, Queen of Heaven, rejoice, alleluia. The Son you merited to bear, alleluia.
Jesus said, alleluia. Pray to God for us, alleluia. Rejoice in the death of Virgin Mary, alleluia. Because the Lord is to see resistance, alleluia.
O God, who by the resurrection of your Son,
our Lord Jesus Christ, granted the joy of the whole world,
grant we beseech you that through the intercession of the Virgin Mary, his sorrow,
we may enjoy the happiness of eternal life, through the same Christ our Lord. Amen.
Saint Joseph, Saint Walter, God is good and all the time. Raise the roof. Greet one another. Happy Easter! Happy Easter.
Please join us in singing our closing song, Alleluia, Love is Alive. The words will be on the screens.